What up, everybody? Back with another one. Back with another one. Y'all know what it is. Here watching another episode of I was about to say Uncharted Outlander. Episode 9. So I guess they're going to continue with this war. A war that they know they're going to lose. You know? And it's like, let's try to change time. But yeah, that's what we're getting into. Yeah, let's just hop right into this. Yeah, I know. And I still need to buy my hardcover, especially before I leave. But yeah, let's hop in right into it.
We left Beaufort Castle, 100 strong, and traveled towards Creef to join forces with Murta and the Lallybroch Frasers. But our numbers dwindled along the way. Many who resented being ordered by Lord Lovett from their families and farms deserted our ranks. We'd sent young Simon to persuade them to return, with the promise of land when the war was over. It gave them something to fight for, to die for. If it went according to plan,
we drop the warm-up.
Thank you. Milady, milord!
Fergus, laddie. You look fit.
Fergus!
No. It's been horrible. He forced me to mend his socks and to fetch his meals.
Yeah. Just trying to educate the lad in the finer place of traveling in the Highlands.
All right, children.
When is Jack Black Randall gonna die? And we're gonna see it. I guess his death is gonna come later. Maybe this season.
Have a word with the ladies. Try and get them to make as many bannocks as possible today.
Mrs. Clare, I washed my mouth out with whiskey in preparation for a big bus from you.
Oh, whatever.
Anger.
Got it.
Oh, good to see some things haven't changed.
It's been hour long, Clare.
Been a nice minute since I've seen these peoples.
Where's Willie?
He died.
Something happened.
Tell them.
The lad
Got married. Oh, we're gonna see him in America. Ah, cool. Dougal!
Hey. You look well, lad. Despite the misfortunes you suffered.
Never felt more fit.
And the Lady Brock Turach.
A vision of true loveliness.
Well, it wouldn't be Scotland without you, Dougal.
Call him change his mind, then.
Is there a clan Mackenzie to join the cause?
Colum's mind is his own. It's no concern of mine.
We are here. Pledge our hearts and swords to the glorious cause.
What? Just the three of you?
Well, you didn't question the lad's strength in numbers when they stormed Wentworth Prison in the very teeth of over 200 redcoats.
It's 400 out of it.
They're likely five.
Oh, lad.
Glad you joined the Jacobite cause. I was so proud.
Mm-hmm.
It's as if my own son was taking his first steps as a man. Now, I know that you and I have had our differences in the past, but I have been waiting for the day when we would fight together on the same side. It is our time. For glory.
Two.
For Scotland.
I don't think y'all winning, but you know what?
Then I welcome your heart. And your sword. All of you. Sorely needed. You can aid me in training the other men.
That should be a simple enough matter.
I know it's kind of negative to say, but it's like, we already seen that she came back to present day, well, her present day, and was looking to see if he won the war, and nothing changed, so.
Smiths must have even held a weapon, let alone used one in a fight. Now, this is good ground to train upon. So, I've decided to stay here for a time.
Your mind's set, then?
Aye. Tis.
Good to see you looking so pro, Dickle.
All right. We'll make a fine group of Highland soldiers.
You better.
Time to waste.
One way they can change history is instead of fighting when it says, delay it a year. That'll change history.
Are going to learn them. Now, form lines. Two. When you hear this. Two lines. One directly next to the other.
Here. Put your toes there. Line.
Get in line! Kinky! Move your ass!
Do you think the enemy's gonna footer away waiting for you to gather?
And when do we get proper weapons, huh?
First, you learn where to stand. Then, you learn how to move. And if you can manage the particulars of that, we'll put a sword in your hand and teach you to kill the red.
You, the fuck you talking about?
Your own left. What is the
You don't want to be around that, huh?
Just playing.
I asked you to get water for my lord, did I not?
Yes, but I was just...
I don't care. Just come with me.
Keep your distance! Dressing!
Man. I was thinking, like... Who would even care about the dude that's playing that little flute or whatever? Like, do you... Like, what, are we literally waiting for them to line up? And they line up? Could you imagine someone having a grenade? Ah, they're throwing rocks at us. Yep, I'm throwing a rock at you, all right. Ooh, that would be crazy. Someone should totally make a freaking, a show like that. I should write a book like that. Someone from the military goes back in time to I don't know, the 1700s or something like that.
You have the princes here, no?
I can trust Stuart well enough.
Right, good. Because more clans are joining our cause every day, and their leaders are jockeying for position within his inner council.
More pressing concerns and worrying about securing a seat at the prince's table.
And I'll send these carters into battle until they're well trained and disciplined.
I know that's right.
Not exactly Delmonico's steak, is it?
Ma'am?
Well, that's what we think you Yanks have for chow every day. Giant steaks, baked potatoes browned in butter, tomatoes the size of cricket balls, and vats of chocolate ice cream.
Don't I wish?
Yeah, we just get K-rations, pretending to be real food. We call it shit on a shingle. Sorry, ma'am.
It's quite all right. I'm Claire Randall, by the way.
Corporal Caleb Grant. It's Private Max Lucas.
Claire Randall.
Airborne. Separated from your unit.
Yes, ma'am. Ever since D-Day.
There's quite a lot of that going around.
Together, you clubs! Together! By the left! Quick! March! Start of... Hold. Hold! Now!
Foolishness. And games. That's what you're thinking. No reason to learn to strut and ponce about like the Redcoats. We're Scotsmen.
We're brave. We're strong.
We have God on our side, so why should we waste time with all this shit?
No. Oh.
I was like that. And I went to France.
He wants to fight.
I became a soldier. I saw what a modern, well-trained army can do.
Oh, it's a pretty sight at first.
See them all marching together in their neat rows and columns, music, playing.
Banners waving. So pretty. You want to smile.
I laughed too the first time.
And they fired the first volley.
First, you see the flash of metal in the...
They had this in a museum somewhere where a dude's chest plate was hit by a freaking cannonball. No.
Tearing across the field like a sheet of metal rain.
Never in my life would want to have... No, that'd be crazy.
Sound of gunfire.
Rolling thunder across the hills. By the time the last of it fades, the second volley is already on its way.
I realized... It takes more than courage to beat an army like that. It takes discipline. It takes a well.
It takes a well-trained soldier.
Now, if we have the discipline to stand together, to march together, and to fight together, then by God, we will win together.
Reicha!
Reicha!
Stand! Stand! Hold!
Come on! Hey! That's how you beat the Red Coats, eh? With iron charge!
Mm-hmm. Yeah. There you go. Yeah.
Get back in line! Back in line there!
There's only five of us!
I imagine $1,000 screaming descending on the pretty redcoats lined up in a row! They're run like chickens!
We need surprise for the charge to...
There's barely any life in her. I kind of figured it out.
Why?
I can see she's not being herself.
Yeah?
Claire doesn't usually beat around the bush. She speaks her mind, whether you want to hear it or not.
I asked. She claims she's fine.
It's going to take a bit more than asking to pry it out of her.
Come on, you two. Take aim. Fire.
Got something growing between your toes there.
Yeah, just everyday filth.
This is unacceptable. You could easily get trench foot. If you intend to use these feet to march, then you need to take better care of them.
Well, I'll bear it.
Bear it? Trench foot can lead to gangrene, which can lead to amputation. I've seen it happen. Are you completely idiotic? Is that what you want? It's a rhetorical question. Take off your other boot.
God damn. You're...
So, in summation, make sure to dry your boots. Don't go to sleep in your socks. If your feet begin to swell, then coat them in foot powder and let them air dry. Move your legs, wiggle your toes, anything to get the blood flowing. Are you listening? Did you hear what I fucking said?
Oh, shit. She's cracking. She's cracking.
I heard ye.
She can't be around war, bruh. Ooh. Wow.
So she says to me, "Oh, you'll be expecting me to open my legs." I says, "No, I'll just cook it on the pot like everybody else."
Hey, easy, lads. It's just a pack of new recruits.
How do 10 men just walk into the camp without so much as a challenge from the sentries?
I just smiled and waved and they let me pass.
Who's on watch?
Ross and Kincaid.
Bring them to me. Those new guards in that place.
Jimmy, did you know here? I bought volunteers for a...
Place the rod back in the pipe. Good wide stance. Get in the crook of your shoulder.
That's it. That's good.
Wait for my command!
Make sure you take your eight.
Deep breath.
Deep strike should be a killing blow. Again. One.
Fire!
One. She need to get out of there, bro.
Reload.
Appreciate you letting us hit your ride, man.
Hope you find.
Oh, this is probably where her unit get shot the hell up. I hate when I call shit.
Corporal,
side of the road somewhere.
Oh, we just can't leave him there.
I know. But they'll see us as soon as we try to cross the road.
Mm-hmm.
I'll go. I'm a woman. They won't be able to stop
you
me.
You won't get 5 yards.
They will shoot you dead. Are you crazy? Oh, that's a tank. Yo. It's over with, bro. You gotta...
I can see the crowds on the left. I'll try to circle around to the right, see if I can find a way across. Stay put. I'll be back for you.
Okay.
I don't know, bro. You probably gonna get shot the hell up.
He's in top! Oh.
Should have waited. I wouldn't want to be through that.
Shut up.
Ma'am, are you okay? Can you hear me? Ma'am. Come on. What the hell are you doing down here all alone? Are you okay?
Shit. Ooh, that's traumatic.
Clear.
She never told you about the time she was at war. Then you would have got shot the hell up.
You would be dead. Just like the soldier, that corporal.
I know that.
Mm-hmm.
Because I told myself the same thing right after it happened. And I just closed the door on that night. Walked away. I haven't looked back ever since until now. Now I look at Ross and Kincaid and all the others being turned into soldiers, being trained, putting up a brave front. All I can hear is Max Lucas crying out for his mother in the dead of night. And for 2 years, I've tried to stop this war from coming.
Uh-huh.
Now that it's here, I'm not sure I'm ready to go to war again.
I know that's right.
You don't have to. You fought your war. We'll fight this one without you. I'll have Ross and Fergus take you home to Lallybroch.
No.
Claire.
I can't do that either. Listen to me. If I go back, then it will just be like lying in that ditch again. Helpless and powerless to move like a dragonfly in amber. Except this time it will be worse. Because I'll know that the people out there dying alone are people I know. And I love.
I get it, but you know, they fighting the losing battle.
I won't lie in that. Ever again.
All I can say is you can go back to the future, come back with some better artillery. Some automatic guns, you know what I'm saying? All you need is one and a couple of bullets.
I'm going to hold you to that, James Fraser.
You have my word, Claire Fraser.
You're gonna get jumped.
He's just a bear.
I'm 16.
16 or 60, he just made a very credible attempt at cutting my throat.
Who are you, laddie? Why are you creeping around at night? Addressed to a British officer. He's a spy.
I'm no spy. I saw the light of your fires, and when I came to investigate, I recognized you. This was my life. I should greatly prefer not to. But since you have forced the gift upon me, I must regard it as a debt of honor. I should hope to discharge that debt in the future. And once it is discharged, I will kill you.
And I must hope, sir, that we do not meet again.
A grey does not forget an obligation, sir.
Wow. Nobody really care about their name no more.
Those men let the boy get through the lines. You can't continue with this carelessness.
Not from anyone.
That includes me.
What are you doing, lad?
It was our unshielded fires that drew the lad to us.
Jamie. What the? You'll oblige me.
Six flashes for our unshielded fires. A dozen more for my carelessness.
After that, we'll take care of those British troops, Master Bay, so kindly warn us a bit.
I don't think he feel it anymore. I mean, shit. All his nerve endings is probably gone from his back at this point. You know what I'm saying?
So, what are you planning?
I'm going to slip into the British camp. See what trouble we can make.
No idea. Not you. You'll remain here. Sentry duty.
We still have a camp to protect.
I stay behind.
Like some wretched soldier has been given an order by his commander.
That's exactly what he'll do.
Oh.
Good luck to you.
Well, okay. I was about to say, you gotta go in there stealth. They destroyed the tire. See, this is the things I'm talking about. They could have went in there, killed all the men, took the weapons. Did you take their weapons?
Commando. Is that the right word?
Yes. You went to the British camp?
Aye.
Did you go by yourself?
Nah. Couldn't leave my men out of all the fun, could I? We had a very profitable night. Cotterpins from the cannon carriages. Couldn't take the cannon, but they'll no go far with no wheels.
Oh, you couldn't take them. Fair enough, fair enough. It's not like there was roads back then. But shit, bro, I'm telling you, I would have tried to figure out a way to keep those, bro.
It led the lad to confess his camp's location. It'll save lives. Because a hell of a lot of good 16 gallopers will do General Cope stuck out in the woods.
It's not that easy to get wheels, is it? So I guess it's effective. Cause I'm thinking too modern, and I'm like, bro, why? You know how easy it is to get a wheel, and I'm not thinking like it's 1700s. It's pretty expensive to get a wheel, especially. I don't even know how. That's a lot of wheels, so. Yeah, that's effective. I'm with it. I still would have tried to figure out a way to keep those, though.
Do the honor. Ride ahead
and announce our presence to His Royal Highness, Prince Charles Edward Stuart.
As you say.
No turning back now, Sassenach.
I'd say not.
Wow. I'm about to go to war. So technically we got what, 4 episodes left? 10. Yeah, 4 episodes left. Wow. Yeah. I don't even know what's about to happen at this point, because they've been trying to change the future. I don't think they're going to. But then again, maybe they did, maybe they didn't. Who knows until we finally know. You know what I'm saying? So yeah. I hope y'all liked the reaction. If you did, like and subscribe. Leave a comment. Tell me what you think of this episode. And, of course, I'm going to keep watching this. And, want to support the channel. Get my book. And other than that, yeah. Thanks for watching. Deuces.